सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणविदातिपुरो येदागच्छ प्रणोति तस्मै तं हृदेवात्मोक्तिप्रकाशम् ओक्षुरुवै शरणं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमोमियं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेर् दृक्यत्व निर्मलपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परम तदेवान्नमत्तो निर्मिशिकामतिः। ईश्वरस्य जीवस्य च स्वरूपतः भेदाभाव सो अभेद इज बीइंग डिस्क्राइब नाउ बिटवीन ईश्वर एंड जीवा तस्य व्यापकस्य ईश्वरस्य जीवस्य च इज द स्क्रीन नॉट विजिबल ओके या ओके थैंक यू। सो जीवस्य ईश्वरस्य जीवस्य च स्वरूपतः भेदाभावः तस्य व्यापकस्य ईश्वरस्य जीवस्य च स्वरूपतः नास्ति भेदः। इन स्वरूप इन रियलिटी देयर इज नो डिफरेंस इन नेचर द वेरी कंटेंट ऑफ ईश्वर एंड जीवा इज सेम सच्चिदानंद तत्व किंतु उपाधिना भेदो अस्ति। सो भेद इज ड्यू टू द उपाधि माया और जीवा जीवा अंतःकरण और अविद्या सो माया एंड अविद्या दीज आर द डिफरेंसेस देयर। सो अवच्छेदवादे माया विशिष्ट चैतन्यम ईश्वर इत्युच्यते अविद्या विशिष्ट चैतन्यम तो जीव इति। सो बेस्ड ऑन द वाद द सेगमेंटेशन ऑफ ब्रह्म चैतन्य इन कीपिंग विद द प्रतीति इज एक्सप्लेन। सो द एक्सप्लेनेशन मे बी डिफरेंट ईच एक्सप्लेनेशन may not suit each and every sadhaka, so various prakriyas explain it in different way, so whichever suits you take that, but remember that the differences are pratiti matra differences, they don't make it real. In avachhedavada maya vishishta chaitanya is ishvara, avidya vishishta chaitanya is jiva. In abhasavada though मायया आभासेन च विशिष्टं चैतन्यं ईश्वर इति वर्ण्यते आभास सहित अविद्या विशिष्ट चैतन्यं जीव इति च। सो द डिफरेंसेस आर इन ग्रैनुलरिटी ऑफ व्हाट बिकम्स द उपाधि दैट देयर इज एन उपाधि व्हिच इज क्रिएटिंग प्रतीति ऑफ भेद वेयर एज इन रियलिटी देयर इज नो भेद एट ऑल बिटवीन ईश्वर एंड जीव इट इज सेम इन आभासवाद एज वेल एज अवच्छेदवाद एंड प्रतिबिंबवाद एज वेल। सो इन आभासवाद मायया आभासेन च विशिष्टं चैतन्यं ईश्वर एंड वी हैव सीन दिस इन डिटेल इन द अर्लियर चैप्टर्स सो लेट्स नॉट स्पेंड मोर टाइम हियर। आभास सहित अविद्या विशिष्ट चैतन्य सो आभास अलोंग विद द रिफ्लेक्टिंग मीडियम ऑल्सो विच बिकम्स विशेषण टू चैतन्य दैट इज जीव। नाउ वेदर इट इज विशेषण और उपाधि that will make or break the sadhaka's understanding. Visheshana is due to which one remains in avidya. Once it is understood as upadhi, then there is no difference between jiva and ishvara. Tatha eva avachhedavade avidyayaha mayayascha bhedosti. In avachhedavada, avidya and maya are treated differently. So there are people who say avidya, how can individual as avidya be same as this maya which is shakti? So avidya is considered as a flaw, whereas maya is considered as a shakti. इन आभासवाद स्वरूपतः चैतन्यस्य भेदो नास्ति इन स्वरूप चैतन्य इज सेम वेदर इट इज क्वालिफाइड बाय माया और अविद्या डिलिमिटेड बाय माया यू सी इट थ्रू विच कलर्ड लेंस दैट चेंजेस द लाइट बट द लाइट इज नॉट रियली चेंजिंग दैट चेंजेस द विजन ऑफ द लाइट सिमिलरली हियर स्वरूपतः चैतन्यस्य भेदः नास्ति बिंब प्रतिबिंब पक्षे अज्ञानगत चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब जीव बिंब चैतन्यम ईश्वरः इन दि प्रतिबिंबवाद दि बिंब चैतन्य ओरिजिनल चैतन्य इज ईश्वर एंड अज्ञानगत चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब इज जीव इन अविद्या देयर इज अ रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ चैतन्य विच परवेड्स इन इट्स कार्य इन दि सूक्ष्म शरीर ऑल्सो अंतकरण ऑल्दो वी अंडरस्टैंड दिस अंतकरण प्रतिबिंबित चैतन्य इज जीव रियली इट इज अज्ञानगत चैतन्य अज्ञाने प्रतिबिंबित चैतन्य बट द मेन डिफरेंस इज बिंब चैतन्यम ईश्वरः दिस इज द विवरण पक्ष बिंब प्रतिबिंबवाद वेर ईश्वर इज नॉट ट्रीटेड डिफरेंटली फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म सगुण ब्रह्म इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड एज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म एट ऑल बिंब चैतन्य इज ईश्वर The original Chaitanya itself is Ishvara, whose reflection is the Jiva. This is the main difference there, so to say, in which is the original. Asmin pakshe api Chaitanyasya swarupataha nasti bhedaha. There is no difference in this also between Ishvara and Jiva. Since all the three vadas, Jiva is Ishvara even while he is a samsari because the Chaitanya underline is same. Not similar, same. किंतु एकस्मिन्नेव चैतन्ये जीवत्वे ईश्वरत्वे कल्पिते ईश्वरत्व इज आल्सो एज कल्पिता जीवत्व भाव जीव भाव अयम अर्थो अग्रे आवर्तेषु कथयिष्यते सो इन बिटवीन 451 एंड 456 दीज पॉइंट्स आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कस्ड तथा च जगतकर्ता सर्वज्ञः सर्वशक्तिमान् स्वतंत्रश्च ईश्वर एव स च ईश्वर व्यापकः So, Jagatkarta is not Jiva. Jagatkarta in all pakshas is Sarvajna. Has to be Sarvajna. We have seen that. Without having the jnana of the karya to be created, no one can create. So, the maker of the pot knows the pot, knows the karya which has to be created and knows the ingredients which have to go into making the karya. Similarly, Jagat is Sarvam. So, Jagatkarta is Sarvakarta and therefore he should know the Karya and he should know the Upadana Karana also. So, this Nimitta Karana, Ishvara, who himself is the Upadana Karana also because Maya is his own Shakti. So, he is Sarvajna. In all Pakshas, in all the Vadas, Ishvara is the Jagatkarta. Who is Sarvajna, Sarvashaktiman and Swatantra. We have seen all this. Such a Ishvara Vyapaka. We also seen this that Brahma Chaitanya is Vyapaka, but here Ishvara is also Vyapaka. Otherwise, Ishvara cannot be sitting in some place and then become a Jagatkarta. All the logical flaws will accrue to such kind of a religious viewpoint also. Tasya Jivasya cha Visheshana Matrena Bhedaha. So, Visheshana, which is really an Upadhi, it is not a Visheshana at all, but Visheshana in the language taken literally in the analysis of the Shabda Mimamsa. When you understand the Vakya, that time there is a Visheshana and that Visheshana taken as literally qualifying the Chaitanya makes a person a samsari jiva, otherwise When known as an upadhi, he is free. Swarupatah nasti bheda jagatak karta kaha iti dvitiya prashnasya evam uttaram. So now the second question has been answered as to who is the karta of this jagat. Is it jiva or ishvara? What kind of ishvara? All that has been answered that it is sarvajna sarvashaktiman swatantra ishvara who is the jagat karta. Mokshasya karanam kim? इति तृतीय प्रश्न से उत्तरम एंड अग्रज देवा हैड आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन इन हिज ओन स्वप्न ही हैड आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन to his Swapna Guru, Swapna Guru, as to what is the Karana for Moksha. And here we have seen all the possibilities as to whether it is Jnana or Karma or Upasana or mixture of Jnana and Upasana or Karma and Jnana. So, five options. When you look at this simple question as to Mokshasya Karanam Kim. Mokshasya Sadhanam Jnanam Eva. So, answer is confirmed that it is only Jnana. Eva, Eva Kara shows you that it is only Jnana without dependency on anything else. So, there is no Samuchaya possible with Upasana, Karma or anything else. Mokshasya Sadhanam Kim Jnanam Athava Karma Athava Upasanam Athava Ubhayam. Whether it is Jnana that leads to Moksha, Karma or Upasana or both. When you say both, then which both? Since there are three preceding. Iti Prashnasya Idanim Uttaram Uchyate. Now the answer is given to this question. Mukte Sadhanam Na Karma. Karma is not the Sadhana for Mukti. Napi Dhyanam. Dhyana is Upasana which is prescribed by the Shastra. So, Dhyanam Api Mukte Sadhanam Na Bhavitum Arhati Kintu Jnanam Eva Mukti Sadhanam. Only Jnana. Atmani Bandha Yadi Satyah Syat Tadatam Tannivritti Rupah Moksha Jnanina Na Bhavet Kintu Karmana Upasana Na Vabhavet. The typo here. So, why is it that Jnana is the Karana for Moksha and not Karma or Upasana? When a particular karma is done, then what are you trying to achieve with that karma? You are trying to get something which is not already attained. So, apraptasya praptihi karmana bhavati upasanaena va. So, upasana or karma are necessary to bring about a result which is not yet sadhya. Sorry, it is sadhya, it is not at siddha. What is already siddha, which is your swarupa, which has never gone away even in the avidya avastha, that siddha avastha cannot be attained with karma or upasana. It is like you have hidden treasure in at home. You don't know where it is, but everyone knows that you have it. You also know that you have it. So, your great 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 grandfather has left some wealth for you, for the family, and that family wealth is there. You don't know where it is inside the house. You know, in old systems they used to dig and hide whatever, you know, the stories we hear. So, this is used as an example in the scriptures as to the wealth which is hidden at in your house. The house belongs to you, the wealth belongs to you. You just don't know where it is. In that case also, you will have to search, of course. So the example is only thus far, that you already have it, you don't know. If you already know and then you haven't got it yet, then you have to search. Then karma will help. Jnana will not help. Just knowing that I have wealth will not make you. You are already wealthy, of course, but you can't use it. There is no utility of that. But compare this to the necklace which is hidden beneath a cloth and you think it is lost. Or even the early example, you think it is lost, but it is not lost, you already have it. So there are so many examples given to drive home the point that what is not really lost, there karma will not help. If you search all around, still you will not find the necklace. Just jnana that you have the necklace hidden under the cloth, it is already around your neck, but it is covered by a cloth. Then someone has to tell you that it is hidden under your cloth. Or maybe you were searching and just pops off. But the search didn't lead to it. What led to it is jnana. So the differentiating factor there is jnana. What karma can achieve? Only karma can achieve. In karmakanda, every destination to be reached, every phala to be acquired, has to be acquired not by knowing alone. You have to know what is the means, but you have to perform those steps of the method given to attain the goal. Whether it is through karma or upasana, in that case jnana is not going to help you. But what can be attained by jnana can be attained by jnana alone as well. No amount of karma or upasana will help you. Another way to look at it is something that comes up in the bhashya. So if you think about a result, you quantify the result. How much effort do you need to put in to get a particular result? So you look at a result, any result which has to be attained. Praptasya prapti will be jnanena. But apraptasya prapti karmana upasanena va. Something that you don't have, you want. If you want wealth, how much wealth do you want? Based on that, you will have to put as much effort. More karma is needed, more effort is needed to get more result, more dhana ityadi. So, what you are trying to achieve here is purnatvam. Purnatvam is anantyam. So, if you apply the logic, the same logic you extend as to wanting more result, I need more effort, I need so much karma. It is quantifiable. It has a proportionate effort needed. So, for purnatvam, anantyam, what kind of effort will I need? Ananta effort. Ananta effort makes no sense because moksha will be unattainable. If it is attainable through karma or upasana, you will be struggling forever but will never reach it, because infinite karma will need infinite janmas. And still, infinity is what? It is never reachable. So, moksha will be a pipe dream. It is impossible. Logically, only infinite karma can give you infinity. And infinite karma is not possible. So, logically, you cannot attain purnatvam through karma. But what does Shastra tell you? Moksha is possible. That anantya moksha is possible. Nitya moksha. And we have examples in the Shastra. We know of gurus who have attained moksha. So that tells you anantyam is possible. So this purnatvam, anantyam, nitya moksha is an impossibility if it is through karma. And it is possible as well. Just give me a moment, please. Sorry. So, anantyam is possible and it is not possible through karma, then the only option, parisheshyat, is it is possible due to jnana, because you are already that. Parisheshyat, the only possibility of getting nitya moksha, since it is not possible through karma or upasana, and yet it is possible, then it means that you are already that. It is something which you can never attain. Because infinite karma or upasana is needed to get to that infinity. And infinity is possible, nitya moksha. Then the only possibility is you are already purna, already ananta. And if you are already ananta and you still feel antavat, then the only way anantyam can be attained is being praptasya prapti. It will be only through jnana. So you have to remove the misunderstanding of antavattvam. That will go only by jnana. And jnana alone. There is no expectancy of anything else, because everything else being limited cannot give you limitless result. So, if one is sufficient, the other tag along will not give you anything. In fact, it will oppose the jnana also. Karma is opposed to vritti rupa jnana. Aikya vritti rupa jnana, not any vritti rupa jnana, aikya vritti rupa jnana. So, mukte sadhanam jnanam eva. Atmani bandha yadi satya syat. Had this bandha been real, then tada tannivritti rupaha moksha jnanena na bhavet. Just jnana won't be sufficient, then karma or upasana would be expected. Kintu karmana upasanena va bhavet. Bandhaschatmani na satyaha, kintu rajju sarpavat mithya. And we have also seen as to, even if we were to say that bandha is satya, and nivritti rupa karma or upasana would be needed for its nivritti, tannivritti rupa moksha karmana upasanena va bhave would be possible, but it is an impossibility. This is what we analyze. So although the sadhu says that it is, had bandha been real, then karma or upasana would have been a possible solution. Not that they would have been the solution, they would have been possible. Here, impossibility is being talked about. Bandhaschatmani na satya kintu rajju sarpavat mithya. And this mithya sarpa will never go away. Through karma and upasana, if you start beating around the rope thinking that it is a snake, it won't go away, it will still be there. No amount of karma will take away the mithya sarpa. Only jnana will take away. Rajju jnana will take away the mithya sarpa. Similarly, in the case of ajnana, going away by jnana alone, but not by any amount of karma or moksha, because ajnana is the karana for every karma. So it is not opposed to it. What is not opposed to something cannot take away. Cannot take that away. So tasya mithya bandhasya nivrittihi adhisthana jnaneneva bhavet karmana upasaneena va na nivarteta. So sarpa will not go, mithya sarpa will not go by karma upasana ityadi. Nivritti is possible only through adhisthana jnana, meaning rajju jnana. Yatha rajjo sarpaha kayapi kriyaya na duri bhavati kintu rajju jnaneneva duri bhavati tatha आत्मज्ञानात् प्रतीयमानः बन्धः तत्कारणभूतम् अज्ञानं च आत्मनः ज्ञानेनैव निवर्तेयताम्. सो रज्जु ज्ञानेनैव दूरीभवति मिथ्यासर्पः, नॉट गो अदरवाइज एट ऑल. सिमिलरली आत्मज्ञानात् प्रतीयमानः बन्धः, वाई प्रतीयमान बन्ध, दिस बन्ध इज नॉट रियल, देयर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ बन्ध. That pratiti will go away. That bandha which is pratiyamana will be seen as mithya. So pratiti may continue, but in understanding it will go away. Therefore, bandha pratiti is not real. It will be known as not real. So tatkarana bhutam ajnanam cha atma jnaneneva nivartetam. So this pratiyamana bandha will go away, as well as its karana. If the karana remains, then it may sprout again. So karana has to go for the bandha to not crop up again. Karma upasana yor moksha sadhana tva bhavaha. So karma and upasana are not moksha sadhanas. Karma upasana yor phalam anityam tabhyam nityaha moksha na siddhyati. So you cannot get a nitya result from an anitya sadhana, which is what we saw a little earlier. Moksha yadi karmana phalam syat tada moksha anitya bhavet. But if you are still insist that moksha is attainable through karma, then whatever is attainable through karma will go away in time. Therefore, it will be anitya. Moksha will be anitya. Krishyadi karmanam phalam annadikam anityam bhavati. Otherwise, a farmer grows the produce once and then he is done for life. That doesn't happen. So the anna ityadi grown goes away, it is consumed, or it rots away. If it is not consumed, it will rot away. Phalgutaya लियते इति फलम. सो एवरी फल इज द वेरी वर्ड फल इज बिकॉज इट रॉट्स और इट यू नो इट डिसइंटीग्रेट्स goes away in time. That is why it is called as phalam. Phalgutaya liyate iti phalam. Krishyadi karmanam phalam annadikam anityam bhavati. Yajnyadi karmanam phalam swargadikam api anityam. So swarga ityadi also, even if one attains, it may be longer, much 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 longer than the human life, but still it will be anitya. Tad yatha karmajito lokaha kshiyate evam eva mutra punyajito lokaha kshiyate. परीक्ष लोकान कर्मचितान ब्राह्मणो निर्वेद माया नास्त्य कृतकृतेन इत्यादि श्रुति भी कर्म फलस्य अनित्यत्वं वर्णितम्. सो मुंडकोपनिषद एंड छांदोग्य टॉक अबाउट दिस अनित्य रिजल्ट बीइंग अनित्य फल बीइंग अनित्य जस्ट लाइक थिंग्स हियर. सो दिस तद्यथा कर्मजितः लोकः. कर्मजितः इज कर्मकृतः. दिस लोकः लोक्यते इति लोकः कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति. सो लोक इज एक्सपीरियंस. इफ यू टेक इट एज लिटरल डेस्टिनेशन टू बी रीच देन ऑल्सो इट होल्ड्स गुड वेदर स्वर्ग लोक टू बी रीच और एक्सपीरियंस अर्न बाय कर्म द भोग लोक लोक्यते इति लोकः एंड देन इट विल मीन भोग भुज्यते इति भोगः दैट भोग और लोक विच इज अर्न बाय कर्म. Karma includes upasana also because upasana is manasika karma. So yatha karmajitaha lokaha iha kshiyate. Here itself. Because amutra is there. So we have to understand iha. Because where else have you seen karma? In any other janma you have seen karma. That is not valid because the anubhava is not at the forefront of this smriti. What you see right now, that is your anubhava. So it is yaha loka anubhava. We see it all goes away. You cannot hold on to any moment, any result you cannot hold on. So since you cannot hold on to any result beyond a particular time, it is anitya. Kshiyate. Evam eva amutra punyajitaha lokaha kshiyate. Papajita also, but here nobody is interested in Naraka. Nobody is working towards Naraka. Everybody is working towards Swarga, Sukarupatvat. Sargasya Sukarupatvat, everybody is working for Sukha. Everybody is working for Swarga, therefore. This is what the Mimamsaka's argument is. Everyone wants Swarga. Why? Sargasya Sukarupatvat. So, Punyajitaha Lokaha Swargava, beat Swarga. As a literal loka, or it can be swarga anubhava, sukha anubhava. That will also go away in time elsewhere, amutra. So it is anitya. Why? Phalatvat. Simple reason, phalatvat. And what is the hetu? Phalatvat. Why is it a phala? Because it is karma krita. So karma krita phalatvat, punyajitaha lokaha, amutrapi kshiyate. Therefore, what should one do? You don't need to go elsewhere to analyze that the phala is nitya or anitya. That analysis, you don't have to travel to another loka. You can sit here and do the analysis. How? Pariksha lokan. Having examined what? Lokan. Lokan is again karmani utpatti. Not other lokas. The anubhava, here itself you analyze your experience, whatever be your age, everybody has experiences. Once one grows up enough to analyze, one understands that the anubhava is going to last only for a particular time. So the loka, anubhava, bhoga lasts only for a particular time. Pariksha lokan, anubhavan, which are what? Karma chitan. They are result of karma. Brahmanaha nirveda mayat. Nirveda has the meaning of vairagya. So one would get vairagya from the very karmas, because whatever one has been trying to search for isn't a result of any karma. So why would anyone waste time doing karma which gives anicca result? Thereby one understands what nirveda maya, how nasti akrutaha krutena. Akrutaha nityaha, only akruta will be nitya. Krutena karmana akrutaha mokshaha nasti. This moksha which is akrutaha is not a result of, it is not karma jita ityartha. Karma chitaha, karma jita, both same meaning there. Krutena karmana upasanena va akrutaha moksha nasti. Therefore what? Karma and upasana vairagya is udbhuta for this brahmana now. Then he should go and search for a guru. This is what the Mundaka Upanishad says. So what should he do? Sa guru mevabhigachet shrotriyam brahmanishtam. So samitpani. Sa guru mevabhigachet samitpani hi shrotriyam brahmanishtam. That kind of guru he should approach and do shravana mana nidhyasana. Why? Because jnanena eva mokshaha natu karmana upasanena va. Ityadi shruti vi karma phalasya anityatvam varnitam. Karma phala is anitya. Mokshasya karma phalatvangi kare saha anitya bhave. Similarly, if moksha had, if moksha were to be accepted as a karma phala, then moksha will be anitya. Who wants this kind of a moksha? No darshanika will say that my moksha is anitya. Tasmat moksha na karmana phalam. So moksha is not a karma phala. There are some quotations given in the tippana. Bhavanajam phalam yat syat yatcha syat karmana phalam na tatsnasvati mantavyam panyastri gamanam yatha. Bhavanajam phalam yat syat yatcha syat karmana phalam na tatsnasvati mantavyam dravideshvival sangatam avirodhitaya karma na vidyam vinivartayet vidya vidyam nihantyeva tejas timirasangavat. So naishkarma siddhi and Brihadvartika have been quoted to show that bhavanajam and karma phalam, karmanaha phalam is not nitya. It should not be considered as nitya, and some examples have been given like that. But what is the real source for or means to moksha? Vidya avidyam nihanti eva tejaha timira sangavat. So this is the tatparya. So Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya Vartikakara says in Naishkarmya Siddhi, vidya jnanam avidya ajnanam nihanti eva. Like the tejaha, like light destroys timira sanga. We'll keep to it as darkness. So light is opposed to darkness. They cannot exist together. Similarly, vidya and avidya cannot exist together. So vritti rupa jnana will take away avidya, ajnana. And karma and upasana cannot take away avidya, because avirodhitaya karma na avidyam vinivartayet. Karma cannot take away avidya because karma is the result of avidya. In fact, avidya, kama, karma, that is the triad, that is the chain. So there is avirodha between karma and avidya. Mokshaha upasana phalam ityangi karyapi sa anitya eva syat. If you say moksha is upasana phala, then also it will be anitya, because upasana is manasika karma. Upasanam api manasam karma eva. Karma phalasya anityatva niyamat mokshaha upasana rupa karmana api na phalam. So moksha is not upasana phala also. Pancha vidam api karma phalam mumukshoho anapekshitam. So panchavidha karma phala mumukshu anapekshita. What can karma bring about? It can bring about five results, which is not expected by mumukshu. Mumukshu is what? Moksha ichchu. Moksha ichchu is mumukshu. He does not want the five types of results that karma upasana can bring about. He wants the sixth result, which is not a result. Because it is not a result of any karma or upasana, then what is it a result of? It is not a result of anything. It is the very swarupa of the seeker. So the mumukshu, swarupata is already mukta. He does not know. And if he indulges in karma and phala, they won't give you the result of moksha, because moksha is not a result. And karma or upasana can give you only one of the five types of phalas, which are those. Karma kurvataha tena karmana utpattihi aptihi vikara samskaraha nashaschaiti panchavidam phalam jayate. There are only five results. One or more of these are resultant of a karma, whether it is utpatti. An example for utpatti, all these are given. Utpatti is something which is newly created, a product. Something can be produced from karma. Apti, one can attain something through karma. You can reach a destination. Vikaraha, you can modify something already existent through karma. You can purify samskara, you can purify something through karma. And nasha, you can destroy something through karma. These are all, of course, I mean, not Vedantic terms, as in Veda, if you inquire into it further, then you'll know none of these are really possible. But what you are looking at the Vyavaharika level also, what can these bring about? What can karma and upasana bring about? They can produce something, they can make you reach somewhere, you can travel and reach somewhere, modify something already existent, you can purify by sprinkling water, etc. Wash your clothes, whatever. Nashascha, and something which is there, adarshanam. Nasha adarshani. So you can make something disappear. That's the real meaning, but nasha, you can say, you know, take, destroy in the laukika sense of the word. So utpatti is what? Padarthasya utpatti, any ghata utpatti ityadi. Any padartha utpatti is possible through karma. Apti padarthasya prapti, you attain something or you reach a destination. Vikara padarthasya puro rupa parityagina rupantara prapti. So attainment of a different form from the earlier form of a padartha can be attained through karma, can be brought about through karma. Samskaraha padartha gata malanivritti rupaha. See, you remove the impurities from a particular padartha. That is possible through karma. Padarthe gunadhana rupascha iti dvividha. So other possibilities, you add some, you know, purifying things to a particular product, padartha. So these are the two types of samskaras. Nasha is padarthasya dhonsaha, destroy something. Iti karmajanya phalasya pancha prakaraha bhavanti. There are only five types of results of karma. Esha madhye kimapi phalam mumukshu vishe na ghatate. Mumukshu is not looking for purifying himself, etc. He is not creating another version of himself. He is not going to want to reach a particular loka, because he wants moksha. He does not want this anitya moksha, which is talked about in Puranas. He is looking for nitya moksha. He does not want to go to Vaikuntha or Kailasa. That is not moksha for him. So prapti, aptihi, that is not what he is looking for. He does not want to become a different kind of a person. He does not want to reach somewhere. He does not want to purify himself. He does not want to morph himself into something else. And he does not want to, definitely he does not want to destroy himself. He does not want to destroy his body and say that is moksha. So none of these results are fitting the mumukshu's goal. His search is not going to end with any of these results being achieved by any of the karma or upasana. Atascha mumukshur jnana sadhana shravanadeva. Sorry. Atascha mumukshu jnana sadhana shravanadeva pravartate na karmana, na karmani. Sorry. So karmani na pravartate mumukshuhu. But where does the pravritti of mumukshu be? Where is it? Where should it be? Rather, jnana sadhana only. Why? Because jnanena moksha, karma is going to give you these five results. You don't want these five results. You don't want any of or all five results put together also is not what you expect. Therefore, you the mumukshu should indulge in shravanadi. So, shravanadu eva pravartate mumukshu na karmani. Yatha kulalasya karmana tasya ghatotpatti rupam phalam siddhyati. Tatha mumukshu karmana mokshotpatti rupam phalam na siddhyati. Now, in detail it is explained as to the kulala is going to create the pot by karma, but mumukshu is not going to create moksha through utpatti of it, through karma. Sarvartha nivritti paramananda praptischahi moksha, because mumukshu is looking for moksha, which is dukkha nivritti, atyantika dukkha nivritti and paramananda prapti. यथा रज्जौ सर्पनिवृत्ति नित्यसिद्धा तथा आत्मनि दुःखनिवृत्ति अपि नित्यसिद्धा. दिस दुःखनिवृत्ति इन आत्मा इज नित्य, इट इज ऑलवेज दुःखनिवृत्त. आत्मा इज आनंद रूप, सो परमानंद रूप आत्मा कैन नॉट हैव दुःख. सो नित्यसिद्ध, इट इज ऑलरेडी सिद्ध. सो प्राप्तस्य प्राप्ति, सिद्धस्य मोक्षस्य प्राप्ति ही कर्मणा न भवति. टिप्पणकार से यथारज्जौ व्यावहारिक सत्ता का सर्पस्य अभाव रूपा सर्पस्य निवृत्ति ही नित्य सिद्धा. So you ask a person who is scared, where is the sarpa? He says it is right here in front of me. He points to the Rajju, says this is where the sarpa is. So the sarpa is in Rajju. Similarly, dukkha should be in Atma, because Atma is Pratyagatma. One says I, aham, ahantaya Atma vartate. So I say aham dukkhi. Aham is Atma. So dukkha should be in Atma, just like sarpa is in Rajju. But you inquire into it further. Once this Rajju is known, then you ask the person who was scared of sarpa, the sarpa that you saw, which is not there now, where has it gone? Where was it? Where will it be? So he says the sarpa isn't there. It won't be there later also. So was it there when he saw sarpa in Rajju? Was the sarpa there? It wasn't there. Even he wouldn't say that sarpa was there. Similarly, this dukkha, which is anubhuta for a samsari, it is not an atma even when it is anubhuta. Because on moksha, here one will realize that dukkha is not there in atma, won't be there, and it wasn't there as well. Therefore, it is nitya nivritta, just like this. Sarpa in Rajju is nitya nivritta, meaning sarpasya nivritti hi Rajjau. In Rajju there is a sarpa nivritti. When is it? Nitya siddha. It is always nivritta. There is never sarpa in Rajju. Similarly, there is never dukkha in Atma. That is said here in the Mula as dukkha nivrittirapi atmani nitya siddha. That is why it is praptasya prapti. Atyantika dukkha nivritti is praptasya prapti. Paramananda prapti is also praptasya prapti. Atma paramananda swarupa. Atma is always paramananda swarupa. Tasmat paramananda prapti rapi nitya siddha. Nitya siddha is again what? It is praptasya prapti. The effort for that is praptasya prapti. Yatha vismrita kanta chamikarasya praptir yathava grihe guda nita nideh praptir nitya siddha. Even if you search for the necklace around your neck, which is already around your neck, or you search for the hidden wealth in your house, it has already attained. It is the search for the already attained. Tatha nijaswarupasya paramananda prapti sarvesham nitya siddha. But in the guda nihita nidhi case, it is hidden in the house, you are going to search. That search is karma. If you argue that, yes, Shravana Manana Nidhyasana is also karma. But what is the difference between that karma and the Karma Kanda karma? The difference is that Karma Kanda search is not a search for something which is already attained. You are going to bring about some result, you are going to reach some destination, etc. Whereas here you are trying to find something which you already have attained. Further, the result of the earlier will be anitya, this will be nitya. Also, the search which is there in the earlier case, where karma, it is not search, it's karma trying to bring about a result. Karma or upasana are prescribed by the shastras, linking the sadhana to the sadhya, which is yet to be attained. Whereas this nitya siddha cannot be a sadhya at all. So in the other case, in the jnana kanda, shravana manana nididhyasana also, although, you know, technically shru dhatu is there, man dhatu is there, then jhai dhatu is there, where sanpratyaya has brought about dvittvam, abhyasakarya has taken place, there jhai chintane dhatu is there in nididhyasana. In the earlier stage, manana, man dhatu is there. And in the first stage, shravana, which is the main sadhana for moksha, shravana, has shru dhatu there. So all are sakarmaka dhatus. Thereby they are kriyas, they are karmas. If this is the argument, still it is not prescribed for a phala. The difference between dhyana in nididhyasana and upasana. Upasana is also dhyana. Nididhyasana is also dhyana. The difference is that nididhyasana is not prescribed dhyana for a result. Shastra does not prescribe it for a result. Whereas upasana is that kind of dhyana which is prescribed for a result. Similarly, the shrudhatu, mandhatu, these are not prescribed for a result. That is the difference between what is karma and upasana. It is that which is prescribed for a result by shastra. Vidhi, vidhi nisheda rupa veda. But shravana manana nididhyasana are not vidhis in particular. Shruti does talk about it as shrotavya. Tavya pratyaya is there. So tavya is vidhi. Vidhi linga vat vidhi. So kritya, vidhi and lot. These are all considered as vidhi in Vedas. Why that? Purovimamsaka says the lat lakara is also vidhi rupa in it, considered as vidhi linga. But it is not for a result. The vidhi is a vidhi only when it talks about a result. No vidhi is valid. Even a Purvamimamsaka will not agree with something as a vidhi. He would call things as arthavada if there is no result found with a particular vidhi. So if mantra says, if Shruti mantra says you do this, whether upasana or karma, and there is no result found by the Purva Mimamsaka, he will end up calling it as an arthavada. In the case of Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, he would say all these Mahavakyas ityadi, all these are arthavadas. Why? Because he cannot associate a result with it. There is no result which can be found as mentioned due to Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. Because what is the mantra which leads to it? Shravana vidhi. Atma vare shrotavyaha. So atma should be heard about, should be inquired into, contemplated upon and meditated upon, that atma which is you. So what result is it going to give you? If at all the result has to be enforced by anumana, then it will be avidya nivritti. But the result that the person is searching for is moksha. So moksha is only through neti neti prakriya. It is not by attaining something. It is taking away something that you already have superimposed upon yourself, which does not belong, like the sarpa here. So if someone tells you that Rajju Jnana, you should know the Rajju, because by that you will get Sarpa Nivritti, but Sarpa is already Nivritta in Rajju. Similarly, Atma, which is Paramananda Rupa, has Nitya Nivritti of Dukkha. So if you say that Dukkha Nivritti is the result of Shravana Mana Nidhyasana, it is not. Because Atma being known as Atma, which is Nitya Dukkha Nivrittaha, it is not a result at all. So the vidhis are not comparable, and thereby they are not technically, although they are vidhis, they are not really vidhis. One may argue that they are vidhis, because with the same respect they have to be treated. One should be told about the means to the goal, but the goal is already prapta. So there is a huge difference between the Karma Kanda and Jnana Kanda. Therefore, these examples where this Guda Nihita Nidhi Prapti is also Nitya Prapti. That wealth is already yours. You are searching for it, but you are not earning it. The difference is you are not earning it, you have already earned it. You are searching. Similarly, with the necklace around your neck. You already have the necklace. You think it is lost. So you are not going to get a new necklace. You are going to search for it. Searching is definitely a karma, but it is not comparable to the karma of earning. There is a huge difference. Tatha nijaswarupasya paramanandasya prapti sarvesham nitya siddha. Mula ittham swabhava siddhasya mokshasya karmana utpattir na yujyate. यद्वस्तु प्राग असिद्धं तद्वस्तु कर्मणा उत्पद्येत प्रागेव सिद्धस्य वस्तुनः उत्पत्तिर्न कर्मणा भवेत. We have seen this as karma cannot bring about something, karma can bring about something which is not already there, whereas jnana will give you something which is already there. Vedanta sharanam api na mokshasya utpattaye. So this moksha utpatti is not possible through Vedanta shravana. Shravana has to be done, but Kartavyataya has to be done, but it is not going to bring about moksha. Vedanta Shravana api na mokshotpatte shrutam. Kintu naivasti kinchit kartavyam nitya mukta chidatmanaha iti etad arthajnana eva shravanam. It's a neti neti prakriya. You have to understand that you need not do anything. But how will you understand unless you know about it? So the Shastra is revealing to you that you do not need to do anything for moksha, you need to undo. Undoing, unlearning is more difficult than learning or doing something fresh. You cannot undo something which has been done. But here you have to unlearn which you have already learned. Naisargika. Anadikalataha avidya has made us to indulge in kama and do karma. Now we have to undo that. Karma which has been done cannot be undone. How will you undo the karma? It cannot be undone. So what can you undo? You have to undo kama, which relates to karma. So you stop doing fresh karma, earning fresh karma. Therefore, sannyasa is prescribed. If you know that karma cannot give the result that you are looking for, nitya, all circumstances being neutral, what should one do? Pariksha lokan karmachitan brahmano nirveda mayat. Once he has vairagya from karma and upasana, because none of these are going to give nitya result, what is the most logical step? The first step the person should do, the Shruti says, is sa guru meva abhi gachet. So he should go and ask as to what is going to give me nitya phala now. Karma is not going to give me. Upasana is not going to give me nitya phala. What will give me nitya phala? It is jnana alone. So for jnana, he should approach the guru. And then, since there is nothing else to do, he cannot remain in that ashrama and give up karma, because karma upasana is not a valid means for moksha, for nitya sukha. Thereby, karma and upasana, he does not want to do. There is vairagya. And if he does not want to do karma and upasana, which is prescribed by the Shruti for that varnashrama, he cannot remain in that varnashrama. Varna he cannot give up. How will he give up the varna? So, ashrama he has to give up. Thereby, he has to give up because he cannot remain in that ashrama and give up the karma. But he has to give up the karma because he has vairagya towards the karma, knowing well that it cannot lead to moksha. Then the obvious step is to give up the ashrama. Whichever ashrama he belongs to, he will give up. This is the end result of that. This is a but natural process. And of course with the rider that circumstance, other circumstances being neutral. Now this is because we bring it in the modern times, because the earlier type of sannyasa in this era is very difficult. Earlier also it was difficult because Gitacharya said sannyasastu mahabhaho. He said that sannyasastu mahabhaho dukkham aptum ayogataha. Without karma yoga, ayogata is without, a person without karma yoga will have difficulty to attain sannyasa. It's not a joke. But the logical step, if we analyze, is karma and upasana do not lead to moksha. Why will one do karma and upasana? One wouldn't do it. Nirvedam ayat. Then what will one do? Obviously, one will drop the ashrama where one has to do this karma. You cannot say that I don't care for the Shruti Vakya and remain in the ashrama and give up the karma. So either if one remains in the ashrama, one has to do karma, which will not give moksha, or drop the ashrama itself. These are the only ways the person will proceed. Therefore, naiva asti kinchit kartavyam. In fact, one who knows that I am not a karta, he is not an adhikari at all. There is no adhikara in karma. So Shruti mentions, Bhagavan Bhashyakara mentions in a different way. He says that person who knows that I am not a karta bhokta has no adhikara in karma. So what karma will he do? If anybody, you tell the person that you will not get result because you are not an adhikari. Why will one do it? So you are the most brilliant person among your friends. All your friends are, you know, are doing say PhD. You can easily do that PhD, but you go and meet someone in the college, same college that these friends are going to. You do not have a master's degree. You have only a bachelor's degree. They all have master's degree, but you are, they take tuitions from you, let's say, but you cannot get that degree. If the professor tells you that I cannot award you a PhD, I cannot help you out with your PhD because you are a bachelor, you are not qualified. Why would you put an effort in PhD? It makes no sense. Similarly here, of course you can say that it's my interest area. So the example is obviously limited. Each example is limited. This example is also limited, but the comparison is what? Why would one act if one is not an adhikari? And what it means is that you won't get the result. No matter what you do, you are not going to get the result of the karma. Why would you do karma? Phalam anuddishya mandu apina pravartate, says the Vartika. So Puramimamsa Vartika says that. Even the Karma Kandi says that. Let alone Jnana Kandi, Sadhaka, even the Karma Kandi says that phalam anuddishya, without having the phala in mind, manda, even the manda buddhi will not have pravritti in that karma. Mando apina pravartate, kaimuti kanyaya. So if a person is sharp, why would one indulge in karma? This is the question there. Because it is not going to lead to moksha. Kintu naivasti kinchit kartavyam nitya mukta chidatmanah. The chidatma, pratyangatma, which is Brahma abhinna, is nitya mukta. And it has no kartavyattum. Because akarta. And when you say anadhikari as a sadhaka, sadhaka has adhikara, mumukshu has adhikara only in jnana, not in karma, then kartavyam karma nasti. Iti etad artha jnana eva shravanam. So shravana is for artha jnana. To understand that there is nothing which is to be done by Atma, which cannot be done by Atma. There is nothing which can be done by Atma really. So there is nothing which is kartavya for Atma because it is nitya mukta. It is not a karta bhokta. Idrusha jnanotpatti matrena mamasti kinchit kartavyam iti bhrantir nivartate. So this jnana of iti ethadartha jnanaya. What is this complete understanding of what? Naiva asti kinchit kartavya nitya mukta chidatmanaha mama pratyagatmana. Chidatma is pratyagatma. Mama nitya muktaha yaha aham tasya mama kinchidapi kartavyam nasti eva. And this knowledge, when it is there, that will oppose what knowledge? Idrusha jnanotpatti matrena mama asti kinchit kartam was a jnana earlier, which was a bhranti rupa jnana. It was not prama rupa jnana, it was bhranti. Mama asti kinchit kartam, at least something I have to do now. There is a lot to do, planning after planning the entire day. But mama asti kinchit kartam iti bhranti, naiva asti kinchit kartam nitya mukta chidatmanah mama iti jnanena nivartate. That bhranti will go away. Vedanta Shravanad Anantramapi Yasya Kartavyata Pratiti Rasti Sana Tattvavita. So Pratiti, this Bhranti is Pratiti, Pratiti Matra. That Pratiti Matra should also go away. No, I have something to be done. This is that circumstance, you know, circumstantially there are so many things to not take sannyasa or not take to jnana alone. No, I have this work to do, that work. It will always be there. It will definitely be there. And this is what is prarabdha. This is what differentiates a jnani from another jnani. Let alone sadhaka. Jnani is differentiated from another jnani by the prarabdha burden. It does not let go the jnani sharira easily. Sukshma sharira also. I have these things to do. These will keep on coming up. The circumstances force the person into samsara further and further. Even after jnanotpatti, let alone sadhaka who is seeking. So mama asti kinchit kartavyam vedanta shravanarantaram api. So shravana, if it is complete, then jnanotpatti has to take place. You cannot say that shravana is over, I am doing manana nididhyasana, but jnana isn't there. That is not shravana fructifying. Shravana fructify, for a lack of better word, fructifying meaning jnanotpatti, not mokshotpatti. If jnana isn't there and shravana is over, means shravana is not over. It is a misunderstanding of what shravana means. Shravana is not listening. It is not shuddha shravana. Shuddha shravana is no shravana really. It is hearing without anything entering the head. In Hindi they say, no, jis kaan se suna usi kaan se nikal gaya bahar. So it doesn't, people say, you know, it went out the other ear. No, it didn't go out the other ear because it would enter the brain in that case. But in the other case, you heard it and it went out the same ear. So the audio waves fell on the eardrums and they bounced off. That's what it means. Shravana not resulting in jnana is no shravana. At least the stage is not over. One punaf punaf shravanam kuriyat. Because without shravana, jnanotpatti is not possible, and after shravana stage being complete, jnanotpatti not being there is an impossibility. So Vedanta Shravanar Anantarapi, then what is the issue? Yasya Kartavyata Pratiti Rasti. One who keeps on saying that I have so many things to do. Saying in a sense, one may say, but do you really believe that I have to do all this? Then you are a karta. How can you not be a karta? And if you are a karta, how can the shravana be over? If there is something to do, see, one cannot say that, oh, my body has something to do. That's a different story. It is ridiculous to talk in that language also. People will laugh and, you know, you call someone and say, oh, my body has to cook today, my body has to clean, my body has to go there. So next time the person will not call you. You say, what ridiculous language is this? Pooja Swami used to laugh at this, you know. He used to say there are some people who think that they are jnanis, or they may be jnanis also. He says that there's no need to change the language. Why do you need to showcase also that you are a jnani? But to specifically think that I have kartavyatvam, sa na tattvavit, then I won't be a tattvavit. The Tippanakara quotes that jnana amritena tuptasya krita krityasya yoginaha na kinchidapi kartavyam asti chenna sattvavit vijnata brahma tattvasya yata purvanna samsrutihi asti chenna sa vijnata brahma bhavaha bahir mukhaha. So brahma asti chenna sa vijnata brahma bhavo bahir mukhaha. So jnanamrutena, jnanam eva amrutam, tena jnanamrutena truptasya, yaha truptaha, one who is satisfied completely krita krutya. So krutani krityani yena yogina sa yogi krita krutyaha, one by whom everything is as well as done. Why? Because all results are antargata in moksha. Because all karma leading to all results are search for ananda. So sum total of all anitya ananda also cannot give nitya ananda, but you have already achieved nitya ananda because paramananda swarupa prapti has taken place. Thereby the yogi is krita kritya, and the truptaha, due to what? Jnana amrita. He has partaken the amrita of jnana. Na kinchidapi tasya yoginaha kartavyatvam asti, kartavyam asti. There is nothing to be done by that jnani, yogi, who is called as a yogi here, not a karma yogi, jnani, yoga here is with the Aikya. So is there yogi? In the Aikya there is Siddhi. Tasya yoginaha Kritakritya says Kritakritya. Then why will he act on anything? Act out anything. Na kinchidapi kartavyamasti. If that person thinks that there is something to be done by me, asti chet kartavyam kinchidapi asti chet. Kinchidapi kartavyam asti chet. Saha tattvavit na bhavati. He is not a tattvavit. Because tattvavit and kartavya karma cannot go together. Therefore, jnana and karma cannot go together. There is no samuchaya possible at all. Vijnata brahma tattvasya bhauri. Vijnatam brahma tattvam yena. Vijnatam brahmana tattvam yena saha vijnata brahma tattvaha tasya vijnata brahma tattvasya yatha purvam samsrutihi na bhavati. Just like earlier there was samsara, that samsara karma cannot continue. Asti chet saha vijnata brahma bhavaha na bahirmukha saha brahma bahirmukha san. That asti chet, samsruti asti chet, if he continues in samsara the way he was doing earlier, then saha bahirmukha. Bahirmukha is a hetu garva visheshana to sa. Sa bahirmukhatvat vijnata brahma bhavaha na bhavati. Brahma bhava, tattva and bhava have the same meaning there. Brahma bhava and brahma tattva have the same meaning. So that is the reality of this jnanena moksha. And jnanena eva moksha. complete this para. Anenaiva karanena nitya nivrutta anartha nivruttihi nitya prapta ananda praptischa vedanta shravanasya na phalam iti sureshwaracharyaihi naishkarma siddhau nirupitam. So Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya Bhartikakara says in his naishkarma siddhi that vedanta shravana phala is not this nitya Nivrutta anartha nivrutti. Anartha nivrutti is already nitya nivrutta in atma, and that is moksha. That cannot be the phala of shravana. And nitya prapta ananda prapti is no prapti really. Therefore, it is not phala. It is already there. Therefore, tasmat mokshasya utpatti rupam karmanaha phalam mumukshor na yujyate. Moksha is not a phala. Utpatti rupa phala of anything. Not only karma upasana, it is not the phala, utpatti rupa phala of shravana also. Shravana is going to lead to moksha, but not as moksha, moksha phala. It is not a phala. Mumukshuna kankshitani padartha nasha padartha prapti padartha vikara padartha samskara rupani phalanyapi nasanti. The other four results of karma or upasana. Karma can give me five types of results. One of them is utpatti, the first one, which is refuted as applicable in the case of moksha. In the case of jnana leading to moksha as utpatti rupa phala. Or, of course, when you say jnana is not going to lead to utpatti rupa phala as moksha, you are refuting the karma and upasana leading to utpatti rupa phala of moksha. And in that section, we have seen that moksha is not utpanna phala of jnana also, of shravana also. Now the other four also refuted in the case of karma also, karma upasana, as well as it is not a phala for shravana ityadi. सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामूर्तिं अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्या बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्वेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महतदेव अन्नमत्तो नीतिमे निश्चितामतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? नमस्ते.